The problem with your cancel button not working with your input box, I suspect, is from this line here where you're assigning a blank space to the STR cancel clicked variable. You're assigning a blank space. What's actually in the input box when you click the cancel button is no character, or what is what we call an empty string. Now, I've actually tested this, and I want to test it and show you how I test it. I test by setting a breakpoint at the do until loop. I'm going to run or debug your program. When the program code gets to this line, it will pause. We can actually look at the values in each of these variables. And so what I'll do is I'll run your program. I'll enter two values for temperatures, and then for the third input, I'll click the cancel button. But after each value I input, the program is going to pause at this line and allow us to look at the variables, and then we can continue on until the next input and so on. I will start debugging. Enter a temperature for month number one. Click the OK button. The program code pauses here. I can see the number of entries is 1. Of course, the max entry should be 12. The STR temp is 98. That's what I entered. And the STR canceled is, you can faintly see it there, is the quote space quote. Again, that's exactly what you assigned it. Okay. Now, I can continue the program code by clicking the F5, or if we wanted to, we could go line by line by clicking the F8 key. But we're just going to continue. The program is going to prompt me for month number 2. Again, we pause. The number of entries is now 2. Max number of entries should stay at 12. What I entered into the input box is 99. And again, the STR canceled click is the space. One more continue. For the third temperature, I'm going to click the cancel button. Now the program, again, pauses here. Third entry. Notice this STR temp is quote, quote, but STR canceled is quote, space, quote. Okay. That's why when we continue our program, you are prompted to enter a number of months instead of it canceling. Right? So what I'm going to do is actually stop the program, say, yes, you're not canceling out because of the blank space here. You get rid of the blank space. I'm also going to remove the breakpoint. We're going to run the program again. Now STR canceled will equal the empty string. Again, I'll enter two temperatures. Notice there's no breakpoint, so it's not pausing the code. For the third temperature, I click cancel, and it breaks out of the loop, averages the two temperatures, displays it. The program is working fine. I hope that you understand now the difference between an empty string and a blank space.